So we're moving quick. My guys are starting to already complain because I'm asking them why things are not done yesterday. Maybe that's some of the A-type in me because I like to keep moving. And so I don't want to hear that it's raining. I don't want to hear that my wife needs me. I don't want to hear that my kids have softball. And so I know I'm a heartless jerk. I get it.
You said it.
When we get rolling, it's just like, let's keep going. When I'm in Ohio, when we used to build there, there was always a reason it seemed like to find to work. I come to the South and I love it here, but there's always a reason as to why not to work, like the fish are biting, or it might be 40 degrees, or some other nonsense. And so I've had to adjust to the idea that we work a little differently in the Midwest than maybe the people do in the South. So it's not as bad as Florida or Island time, but they're sure trying to be that when they schedule. Ask a guy, hey, so you guys gonna work Saturday, get caught up? And they looked at me like I had two heads. What do you mean work Saturday? And I'm like, because, you know, Lord said work six and the seventh day's rest, so let's work. And they're like, no, you're an idiot. We don't work on Saturday. So anyways, got the gravel brought in. We'll use that underneath with the milled plastic for a vapor barrier when we pour our slab. So the vapor barrier will go down. We've got the underground plumbing, as she showed you, was approved yesterday. And we'll take you up here and show you the layout of the house. The footers are dug. We've just got to clean this up and backfill some of these things. But we should have plenty of gravel here. If not, we'll bring in a little bit more. We decided to go and put rebar in the slab. I don't like a lot of cracking. And so we decided on rebar instead of wire mesh. It's just going to hold it together a lot better. And then, as you can see, it looks like a lot of rock, but it's more of a shale, and when this stuff crushes down and packs, I promise you, this is like concrete. And so the good thing is we're not gonna have a lot of settling up in here. And so we left this last curb in here so that the trucks and tractors can get in and out and do their deal. And we'll go ahead Monday and Tuesday and board this up. But let's take a look and show you where everything's at. So this is the end of the house. We'll have a 12-foot by 8-foot high, 3-panel sliding door that will then look over towards the mountain. And so this first area here is the great room. And then as you move out, that is the sewer that goes out to the septic system. And so the septic guy, when he comes, he'll connect out there, put his clean out, cut that down to ground grade, and then take it over the hill so that the sewage all runs that way. To the right will be an office with some French doors here that go out onto a patio. This is the kitchen. And you have the dining area over there. Same thing you'll have on the front of that set of French doors that open up to a patio over there. And that patio will actually wrap all the way around the end of the house. So you got a big 4-foot by 8-foot island here. And then there's a wall that goes here. So these are your cabinets, your island, and then you're looking out into the great room. That's plumbed for a half bath for your sink, your toilet. There's a hallway that runs over there, and then you catch stairs up this way to the second floor, and then this will all be a family room and 3 bedrooms above with a bathroom. This is for the laundry room, which catches a hallway through here, so it's a pass-through laundry room. And then this is the garage area. We're going to put a drain in the middle and take the water out to the downspout so we can get rid of that if we ever have water. Our well will come in here, and so all of our pump and all that stuff will sit in the corner of the garage, our filtration system. And then you have master bedroom. Common wall that runs this way, so that's your master bedroom. And then you have a vanity, that's your toilet, then you have a shower, and then that's walk-in closet back here. We did go ahead and put some pipe in so that we can run our underground electric in here. And then this is for the propane line, because we're going to have a hot tub eventually, and we want to do that with gas instead of electric because it just won't heat. And then to run the stove. And then the wire will go all the way back around to over where the permit box is, and that'll all be underground, but we won't have that conduit on the outside of the house. And then the meter, I like to have everything as concealed as we can. So yeah, the concrete guy's got to come in here and go ahead and clean this all up, finish forming it, and get this all down, bring our gravel in, so this will all have gravel spread across the entire top, and then we'll pour. So the goal is to prep it Monday, have the engineer inspect it on Tuesday, and Lord willing, we pour on Wednesday. And if I don't get him on Wednesday, I lose him the rest of the week, because he's got some other things he has to do, and it'll fall into the next week. But if they actually pour Wednesday, like they said they could, then we'll have the lumber dropped on Monday the 1st and start framing on the 2nd. And if all goes well, we'll be ready for shingles and some steel June 1st. So it's going to move really, really fast with a slab, assuming my concrete guy doesn't mess that up. And then I found out today that my electrician, which I love, he is from Kenya, and he's going to visit his family June 15th to July 15th. And so he will have to run this by phone, 18 hours away or whatever it is, can, you know, telling his guys what to do. So I'm a little nervous by that. So hopefully he can get a lot of stuff marked out before he takes off. So, but other than that, we're going to work really, really hard to have this all done by Thanksgiving and maybe spend Christmas out here. So again, as long as everybody works as fast as I talk, we're all on the same page. It'll go fine. We'll see. And then we cleared down some more of the hill back there, so we can have a nice pad for the driveway, and then room for either another barn or just gardens or just space, play sets for the grandkids, that kind of stuff. And so we took down some more trees with the mulcher and then graded this out. So that's about it. And if we get the concrete poured next week, we'll come back out and show you that. So, but thanks for watching.
So just showing you guys a little bit of what we had been working on. Not only are we doing the house and getting that all prepped up, but they took down some more trees in the backyard and just really opened up the space that you can see into the next property next door, which is vacant. It's a vacant piece of property. A lot of hills, so it's just a lot of it's not flat. It's kind of unusable. A lot of ravines, but look how pretty the backyard. I mean, it's a very, very pretty view of the back here. So we're not sure. We'll have our, of course, plant some grass. I think I might want to do a garden back here up and tucked up into the corner by the trees, because there's just a lot of flat level space, and it's still further away from the house, but close enough that I don't have to go down to the barn area to try and you know, do some weeding and just check on it, you know, here and there. So I think the closer it is to the house, the better off it will be, so that way animals don't get to it. But I was kicking around kind of putting it up here in this backyard area right here. So it's looking good.